the sixth part of the chapter Acid Bases and Salts. Let's start today's session. Now we are going to study about the uses of salts. These salts are used in different fields over here. Let us take one by one. Sodium chloride is the common salt which we add to our food, and it is also used as a preservative in pickles, meats, fish, etc. And what do you mean by preservatives? Preservatives are those substances which are added to the food in order to keep them fresh for a longer period of time. Second is sodium bicarbonate is used in the bakery for making breads and cakes. So this sodium bicarbonate is used in all the bakery products. Next is potassium nitrate is used as a fertilizer. So this potassium nitrate is used as a fertilizer by the farmers in order to enhance the growth of their crops and to increase the fertility of the soil also. Next is copper sulfate is used in textile industries, electroplating and cleaning purposes. Moving on to the next slide, that is the neutralization reaction in everyday life. Now we are going to study how this neutralization reaction is helpful in our day-to-day life. The first example is in the treatment of soil. Farmers usually need to change the nature of the soil so that their crops can grow well. And certain plants do not grow well if the soil is acidic in nature. Now, how does this soil becomes acidic in nature? The soil may get acidic due to acid rain or by the use of excessive fertilizers in the soil. And if the soil is too acidic, it is neutralized by adding a base like a slaked lime, that is calcium hydroxide, that is CaOH2. Or you can also add quicklime, that is calcium oxide CaO. On the other hand, children, if the soil is too basic, it is neutralized by adding organic matter, such as what are organic matter over here, like manure or composts, which release acids. And in this way, the soil can be neutralized. We can neutralize the basic soil over here. The next example is in the treatment of tooth decay. Children, tooth decay is caused due to an acid that is produced by bacteria present in our mouth. And if we do not clean our teeth properly, the bits of the food remains between our teeth. And the certain bacteria live on these bits of the food and produces acids. Now this acid is the cause of the tooth decay. Now the acid released by the bacteria causes tooth decay. Toothpastes are basic in nature and they neutralize this acid and thus help in preventing tooth decay. Children, that is why the dentists advise us to brush the teeth at least twice a day. The next example is in treating indigestion. As you all know that hydrochloric acid is present in our stomach, and this acid helps in creating right conditions to digest our food. And this acid also kills the germs that might make us ill. So if a person overeats, too much acid is produced in the stomach and which causes indigestion. Now to neutralize the excess acid which is formed in the stomach, an antacid like milk of magnesia is taken. And this milk of magnesia contains a base called magnesium hydroxide. So let's see another examples over here. In treating stings of ant and bee. Children, you must be aware that the sting of an ant and a bee is acidic in nature, because it contains formic acid in their sting. And the pain caused due to an ant's sting or a bee's sting can be neutralized by using bases like sodium bicarbonate solution, that is NaHCO3. Also, you can commonly call it as the baking soda. or you can apply calamine lotion to soothe the pain over there, because the ant sting is acidic and this it is which is neutralized by the sodium bicarbonate solution. Another example is in treating a wasp's sting. The sting of a wasp is basic in nature. Now earlier you have studied that the sting of ant and bee is acidic, so you were applying the basic solution. Now the sting of this wasp is basic in nature. The pain caused due to wasp sting can be neutralized by rubbing vinegar, and this vinegar is acidic in nature as it contains a mild acid which we call it as acetic acid. Another example of neutralization is in treating factory waste. As you all know, the factory waste contains some harmful acids which are very harmful for the environment, and if these acids are allowed to flow directly into the rivers or lakes or any other water bodies, then the acid which is present in them may harm the aquatic plants and animals. So to avoid this damage to the environment, these factory wastes are supposed to be treated with a base, so that whatever the waste which are being dumped into the water bodies, that can be treated. With this, we come to the end of today's session. The next topic, that is acid rain, will be covered in the next part of the video. Thank you.